At steady state, steam flows through an adiabatic turbine. Steam goes in at 4 megapascals, 600 degrees Celsius, and 85 meters per second, and exits at 30 kilopascals, 94% quality, and 50 meters per second. The mass flow rate of steam is 12 kilograms per second. What is the change in kinetic energy, the power output, and the turbine inlet area? As always, pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the Turbines, Compressors, and Pumps main lecture. The link to that 9-minute lecture and all the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. The change in kinetic energy can be written in terms of V2 and V1. We simply substitute the given values to find it. The power output from the equation we derived in the main lecture video, link below, is dependent on the velocities and the specific enthalpy values, so we'll need H1 and H2. We'll come back to this in a second to see if we need more values from the tables besides just these specific enthalpies. And to find the inlet area, we know that mass flow rate is area times velocity over specific volume. This means that to find the area, we need to find the specific volume first. So for state 1, let's go to the superheated tables, and for a pressure of 4 megapascals and a temperature of 600 degrees Celsius, we write down the specific volume and the specific enthalpy. With the specific volume, and substituting the other values we got, we can find the area at the inlet. At this point, all we're missing is H2. At state 2, where we have a quality value and therefore our substance is a mixture, we go to our saturated tables by pressure and look up 30 kilopascals to write down HF and HFG. We use these two values and the quality information to find H2. That's the quality expression that we derived during the quality main lecture video, link below. We substitute these values in the work expression, correct for units, joules to kilojoules, and find that the power output is 14.31 megawatts. If you want to check out other examples in the Turbines, Compressors, and Pumps topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to other lectures of the Thermo course as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!